Jimmy is mad as hell, and he's not gonna take this anymore. Yep. We're doing a detention video for chapter 5, and I think this will be the last one, I'm pretty sure. So let's go ahead and get to it.
I'm going to have to show you the force of my
will. Oh no!
Cycle of cause and effect.
Why are they so stupid?
I don't know.
Yes, may I help you?
All right, let's get this over with.
Why, you ruffian?
I know. I'm horrible.
Glad that's over.
All right. Oh no, she disintegrated. Oh yeah, by the way, I got the rubber band ball.
Time for a little on-the-job training. The face of law and order. Do not forget.
I'll be showing off all the things that I'm
looking at. Sounds like a complete
I'm
idiot.
Disappointed, but not surprised. One moment, I'll get your record. All this fighting. What is it? Video games? Causing property damage? Who do you think you are, young man? You might as well get used to working off your bad deeds. I understand it's quite common in prison. I do not want to see you back here for any reason.
Yeah.
Maggot, you're gonna mow the lawn at Bulwark.
Who are you calling maggot, maggot?
I actually did this one time already, but, I'll do it again. He keeps yelling at me because of my dress code. It's hilarious because I'm wearing, this tuxedo and top hat. I love it. He just keeps freaking out. Oh, shut up.
Hopkins, you're done.
Yep, I sure am.
This is getting kind of familiar.
Yep. You can't catch me. You'll never find me. I'm far too sneaky for you. You cannot catch me, sir. Wee.
Stop so I can beat you.
No. Oh no.
Well, don't they ever come up with anything
James
new?
Hopkins in trouble again. No rest for the wicked certainly applies to you, it seems.
Something.
You know, you really shouldn't struggle when the prefects approach you. You seem to be constantly in trouble, Jimmy. Go see the punishment prefect. Perhaps he can improve your attitude.
Yeah, I doubt
it. I want you to stay out of trouble from now on.
Okay.
Maggot, you're gonna mow the lawn at Bulwark.
Who are you calling maggot, maggot?
Maggot. Uh, 90% of the grass, huh? do what I can. Well, will you shut up about my clothes, dude? I can't change them while I'm on the lawnmower, alright? Glitching with the brass. Especially this time. It's usually not that bad.
Alright, Hopkins, that's enough.
There was never any doubt. Reasons were
simple. You have crossed that line! Hopkins,
I've crossed the line. I will show off the, I'll show off the, rubber band ball, in the main video.
Wow! That was just like all the other times.
Why, you ruffian!
Bullworth 1, Jimmy, see you!
Jimmy,
yeah, I'm totally gonna do what they
really
say.
We're really getting to know each other. Isn't that nice? I'll just bring up your permanent record. I am told that you are always in trouble, Jimmy. Very disappointing. Several prefects have noticed your propensity for violence. Now, Jimmy, why don't you try to show that you've understood the seriousness of all this? That will be all, Hopkins. You may go. You could do a little public service. It'll do you good. Go mow the lawn.
Isn't there a law against slave labor?
Yep, now we gotta do the football field. Things have gotten intense. Yep. But this is the last leg of it. Wow. You know that things have gotten very, very bad once he gets to the point of having to mow the football field. I love it. Every time I pass by him, he's, "Where are your pants?" or whatever. Oh, lordy. Isn't this exciting, folks? This is what you wanted. This is... You know, this is detention. You guys were like, "I really want detention videos," so it's like, okay. You asked for it. Yep. Thrilling stuff, man. Alrighty. I'm almost wondering if I need to just take out the commentary track to this entirely and replace it with some more Psychosis or something. Or at least, you know, just something. Because this is going to be really freaking tedious. I mean, jeez. Ugh. Still yelling at me, huh? Okay. Whatever. Now do you see why I don't normally bother with, doing detention? It seems pretty darn pointless. And the unlockable really just doesn't seem worth it, which you'll see here soon-ish.
That'll be all, Hopkins. You may go.
Jimmy.
Why are you wearing those pants?
Are you gonna keep doing that?
When you can beat that, does it? I'm laying the smack down. I've been wanting to do that for a long time.
Yep.
Gotta make it through this year.
You may wait quietly, Barry. Don't make me come back. Why, you ruffian?
That should not help me. That hurt you much more than it hurt me.
Just like last time.
Yep.
Is that shirt some sort of a joke, Pop? I'll teach you a lesson. This morning, I woke up and saw you in my sight going to
Hopkins. Does he really think that ranting and raving helps anything?
I was hoping I wouldn't see you for a while. Looks like you've been quite busy, eh, Jimmy? You seem intent on claiming the spot as Bulworth's number one troublemaker. Do not fight the prefects. Am I making myself clear? Mr. Hopkins, I am of the opinion that some good works would do you a world of good. Go see the punishment prefect. Now get out of here.
Mm-hmm.
You could do a little public service, it'll do you good. Go mow the lawn.
Isn't there a law against slave labor?
Okay. We're getting there, folks. We're getting there. Oh boy. Yeah. What else is there to say? Not much. You know, when I was growing up, one of my very first jobs, I was a landscaper. And, I used to have to mow, fields as big as this, or, you know, bigger than this, actually. Much, much bigger than this. This is relatively small compared to the jobs that I used to have to do. And, yeah, it was hard physically. Not doing the writing and stuff like that so much, that's relatively easy, but I was gonna say other aspects of being a landscaper, like having to shovel horse manure for 4 hours in the pouring rain. That was fun. Yeah. That was a lot of fun. Yeah. And, pulling vines. I hated pulling vines off of trees. That just sucked. Not only was it extremely difficult and tedious, but by the end of the day, your fingers were just raw. Because you have to, like, dig your fingers into the bark of the tree and stuff. And it was just awful. But anyway, that was my landscaping experience as a kid. I'm ignoring him, he's just yelling at me. I was never... was never, like, a violent person. I was never going around punching prefects or, you know, I was never going around, well, we didn't have prefects in my high school, but I was never going around punching authority figures or doing anything like that. I mean, I got into some fights, you know, in school. I mean, what kid doesn't? I mean, you know. And I was good at it. I mean, you know, I had taken martial arts when I was younger. I mean, I took Aikido and everything, so I knew how to fight. But it wasn't like I went out of my way to, you know, be a troublemaker or to cause conflict or anything like that, you know. You know, so I wasn't really known to be a problem child or anything like that. It's not my younger years. I think that, you know, I had a few bumps in the road when I got older, but, you know, that's a story for another day. I'm not going to really get into it on an LP, but, you know, for the most part, you know, I was basically a normal kid. You know, I didn't get expelled from school or anything like that. So, arthritis and things like that. So, you know.
All right, Hopkins, that's enough.
When you start having older people ailments, it kind of puts a damper on you know, some physical activities and everything. Yeah, I'm gonna punch you again, dude, because I want to finish this up. So, anyway.
Hopkins, is it?
Yep.
Very good.
Mm-hmm, I am very good.
Why, you...
And I never, ever did anything like this. I never went around hitting women.
I gotta get out of here.
Yeah. That's just... absolutely...
Dr. Krabsnitch does not have to...
Okay, I'm a very old-fashioned person. I... tend to,
I always get my
tend to be more on the conservative end
of
things.
Well, what have we here?
If it isn't young Hopkins again. Let's see what we've got, shall we? A teacher had to physically apprehend you. I constantly hear your name associated with misdeeds, Jimmy. I don't like it. What should I do to improve your attitude, young James? You better pay a visit to the punishment prefect. And that's the last I want to hear of you, Hopkins.
Okay. This is the last time through.
You can do a little public service. It'll do you good. Go mow the lawn.
Isn't there a law against slave labor?
So anyway, all right, I'm getting my revenge. I should have.
Maggot, you're gonna mow the lawn at Bulwark.
Maggot!
I love
you can do a little public service. It'll do you good. Go mow the lawn.
There a law against slave labor?
Audio just sounds weird there. Anyway, as I was saying, I tend to be more on the conservative end of things, and I'm very old-fashioned. And as an old-fashioned type of person, I still believe in traditional behavioral sets, like, you know, the code of chivalry and everything. You know, you're supposed to treat ladies with, you know, gentleness and respect and honor and everything like that. So, you know, I'm by no means a feminist, but I mean, I believe that, you know, you should treat ladies with, you know, a modicum of respect. You know, I mean, I think that's That's something that nowadays people kind of have turned it on their head. You know, everything's just sort of topsy-turvy nowadays. Not to get into political discussion, but you know what I mean? It's like, people claim to be feminist nowadays, and yet, I mean, walking around in their underwear. It's like, it's not really... I don't think that empowers women, I think that degrades them, really. I mean, call me old-fashioned, but, you know, I think women would do better to display a modicum of honesty, modesty, you know. But anyway, I don't know. I would like to see that traditional mores and values would make a comeback at some point. You know, I think that they've been out of style for too long. This country is suffering for it. I'm from America, by the way. You know, and maybe I'm waxing too philosophical about it, but whatever. The point is, I would never hit a lady. That's just not something I would do. So anyway, there you go. Let's see what else. I'm trying to think of things to talk about here because this is just so boring. It's like, yeah. Yeah. So, anyway, I think I've got to do 80% here. Initially for my channel, I had intended to do more, like, family-friendly content and everything, but I realized that, you know, a lot of the games that I have really aren't family-friendly, and if I'm going to be LPing them on this channel, well, I can't really be claiming that I have family-friendly content if it's the games themselves aren't, so I kind of sort of jettisoned that idea. I was like, well, okay. I mean, not that I cuss to a fairy well, but I mean, I'm not a sailor mouth person in real life normally, but I mean, I do sometimes use expletives and stuff like that. So I mean, you know, I'm not a puritanical person as far as that goes. So you know, sometimes you'll hear me let a few expletives fly on my channel. You know, especially in the case of games like, you know, Grand Theft Auto or, you know, Metal Gear Solid or something like that, where the game is definitely geared more toward adults and stuff like that. This game is geared toward teens or whatever, and, you know, so the language is kind of appropriate for that, you know. Something that's geared more for all ages. Supposing that I made, like, a Minecraft video or something like that, video series, then I would probably try to tone it down. I probably would not use a bunch of profanity or anything like that. I would try to keep it more family-friendly, so, you know, kids could watch it and stuff. Because I know a lot of kids watch Minecraft and stuff, but you're not going to see a lot of kids looking at, you know, Metal Gear videos. Anyway, that's just kind of the thought process for that. Alrighty, we're almost done. Done.
Alright, Hopkins, that's enough.
There we go. That was the unlock. We earned the prison outfit.
Job well done.
I can't wait for someone to break a rule.
And that was ultimately what we wanted to do with this whole stupid mess. And yes, I'm going to go back to my room and show it off to you. Now that I've rambled on about my life and my beliefs or whatever, my philosophical code, yeah. Let's go back.
I wonder what is this?
I wonder.
Alrighty. Prison outfit. Oh yeah, this is a Green Ninja outfit. You get this for breaking a bunch of bottles. I think 300 bottles or more at the shooting gallery range. The shooting range thing at the carnival. BMX champion. Oh yeah, you get this for breaking all the gnomes, the yard gnomes in the game, which I did. And the prison uniform, which you get for detention. So, I got it. Yep, it's unlocked. There you go. That's what you guys wanted. So, yep, Jimmy is a prisoner. How wonderful. Anyway, I'm just gonna throw him in this, save our game, and then I'm gonna go ahead and record a regular episode, and I'll see you guys then. Peace.